you might have a common list of abbreviations, maybe at your institution, or across Kenya, or in the world, in Rwanda? Okay. So the question is, why can't we just use that common list of abbreviations? Well, what's commonly known or standardized practice inside Rwanda might not be in other countries around the world. And the ultimate goal of linking up all these different data sets is, and the only way that you can link up these different data sets is if they all share the same standard names. So a lot of the problems of biodiversity informatics, they're not just limited to the boundaries of a single country. It's beneficial to look at biodiversity data across many boundaries in many countries. And the only way to do that is if all the different countries agree to use the same list of abbreviations. By list of abbreviations, in our domain, it's just dollar or terms. So it's exactly the same thing, but it's just on a more global scale. And if we can all agree to reuse these dollar or terms on a global scale, then we can link up this information and do some pretty amazing biodiversity analysis with that. But that's a great question. We're thinking on a global scale. John?
Yeah, in a special case where you had a whole consortium of museums who had the same data structures to begin with, one of you could figure out what that meta.xml file should look like, and then you could all use it, and then you could use the abbreviations that you shared that way. It would mean that not just the field names have the same abbreviations, but all the field names were there and had the same abbreviations. So you'd have to standardize a little further in order to be able to reuse the meta.xml file to create the new archives. If you had that standardization, you could do so.